Hypoxia or dead zone is a region in a lake where the dissolved oxygen is below a certain threshold. Fish and bottom feeders in that area basically are suffocating. You have fish decomposing, stuff like that, that contributes to algae. It creates these algal blooms, and algae can be toxic.
So right now we're on the Sister Lakes, not as well known, but open to the university community and the broader public. We're prototyping a platform for the measurement of hypoxic conditions on smaller and medium-sized lakes.
So we put the boat out on the water. It's going to use this temperature sensor to measure where there's variations in temperature throughout different levels of the lake.
Okay.
And if we see a variation, then that's an indicator that the lake health is changing.
It's actually a vessel that's connected to the internet. And so the thing that makes this really unique is the fact that we can control this from the shoreline here, from our laptops in our labs, or we can control it anywhere around the world. Our ultimate goal is actually to provide measurements of algal blooms and hypoxic conditions on Lake Erie, but before we can do that, we have to prototype these platforms on smaller lakes to make sure that they can actually work.
There's not a lot of data for detecting hypoxic regions. With Lake Erie, those models are fed data that come from 10 points placed throughout Lake Erie. So if you can imagine how large Lake Erie is and you only have 10 points to inform you what's happening, it's very sparse. So what this platform enables us to do is to collect data live and feed that into models so that you can have a more accurate model because you have more recent data.
Okay, let me just, okay, so 54 dot blah, blah, blah.
It's still initializing, maybe that's why.
The algorithms that Laura Bolzano is developing are going to live on the internet and then just update the readings and control the boat remotely in an automated fashion. Based on that reading, it then decides where it's going to take the next sample. So if you did this just using a gridded fashion, it would take a while to sample the whole entire lake, but we're actually responding to the measurements as they're being collected. And the boat is basically deciding where to take the next measurement based on where it took the prior measurement, and this reduces the number of the samples that are required to do this. So it could conceivably take all day to sample this lake, but using these algorithms, we're reducing this down to much shorter timescales. So what we'll have deployed inevitably in a couple of years in the lakes is a craft that's much more like a regular boat, maybe not as large as, you know, a big freighter, but in between a surfboard and a boat.
Hey, Brandon, can you stop it?
It's kind of finicky. You can work in the lab, take it out to the field, see that what you did in the lab didn't work out, and you got to go back and rehash everything. I'm not going to complain. It was a lot worse when we were working out like the first weeks of December. We were out on the boat in the lake and we were just like rocking the boat, like cracking the ice as the smaller boat was going out and trying to collect samples. It's a lot nicer in the summer than it is in the winter, I'll tell you that.
So we're looking into understanding better vibrations that are induced during pile driving for deep foundations for bridges or structures. Most of the bridges in the state of Michigan are founded on shallow foundations.